Hi, I'm Dave. We are Access Rock. We are at Getaway Rock Festival, and I get to talk to Jack from Exodus.
How's it going?
How are you?
Yeah, good, man. Good. Just had a great show.
Yeah, you played, and the sun.
The sun
just
came out for
came
us.
Out.
I got a sunburn on a rainy day somehow. I don't know how that happened. But.
It's been a horrible weather all this festival, but
right?
Then you played.
Yeah, the sun comes out and blinds us as we came out. I couldn't see anything. It was, but it was great. It was a good show.
Good crowd.
Yeah, man, awesome. This is the second time we've played Getaway, and it was great both times.
Yeah. Sweden love Exodus.
Yeah, 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 we love Sweden.
Not really fresh, though, with the sun and everything.
No, but, you know, whatever. At least they can see us. You know, we can see the crowd. I like that. So sometimes at night, it's just a big black can't see anybody's face or anything, and the lights shine on you and you can't see anything, so it's a little more interactive during the day, you know.
True.
Which is good.
True.
Yeah.
You are out, you're playing a lot of festivals this summer
we're doing, yeah, we're doing 5 or 6 of them, yeah, this year.
And still you're at the same time recording a new record.
We're working on new stuff, you know. Gary, our the main guy in the band, is out with Slayer right now.
Yeah, I was gonna ask.
So we have Cragen, who's in Heathen,
yeah,
with Lee. It's, I know it's incestuous, you know, but you know, we didn't want to cancel the dates and just, you know, stay home. So so yeah, you know, we're out here just kind of bouncing around. We're actually, Gary's playing with us a couple times on this tour too.
Okay.
Where we're at a festival with Slayer. So
okay.
And he's gonna play. It's confusing, but whatever. You know, it's heavy metal.
Well, you've kind of changed members a few times.
That's true.
From back and forth.
It's kind of like a football team almost.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like the Thrash family.
Yeah.
Everybody plays everywhere.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it's just what happens. I mean, you know, a band is 5 weird personalities to start off with, you know, so it's kind of like having 4 girlfriends and trying to keep it all straight. It just all, you know, there's always a problem, you know, so it's just, you know.
Someone always gets pregnant.
Yeah, exactly.
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 No, but Gary's definitely not leaving, right?
Absolutely
he
not.
He is on this record.
Yeah.
Well.
It's his record.
Are flying and saying,
yeah, people make up all kinds of shit. You know what I mean? Like, you know, they wanna make up some juicy story. I mean, the fact is, you know, I mean, he's in Slayer. Like, what are you gonna say? I mean, Slayer's the baddest, and you know, and he's, you know, they held the door open for him, and you know, and they're great to us, you know. So I mean, we like it, we love it. I mean, Gary deserves it, and we have no problem, you know, with it. So some of the fans have a problem with it, and you know, it's like it kind of, some people, you know, see a band and they love the songs,
yeah,
and some people love the guys.
Ah, true.
You know what I mean?
True.
And so if you have a hang up over the guys or girls, as the case may be, you're going to get disappointed, because people come and people go, just kind of like you said.
True.
So, and
true.
You know, it's like a sports team.
True. You know. Because I was thinking, you said Slayer is the baddest. Because I was thinking, I saw Big Four.
Mm-hmm.
Big Four of Thrash.
Right.
But shouldn't Exodus be?
Well, I mean,
I mean,
the, you know, the thing about the Big Four is that they were the Big Four, and it all comes from, you know, those days, you know, Anthrax and Megadeth and Slayer and obviously Metallica. I mean, they were a bigger band than Exodus even back in the day, just numbers wise, sales wise, and they're the Big Four.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I mean, we never felt like we should have been included in or whatever, you know.
No,
what I mean?
Okay.
All those guys have great things to say about us. We are all friends with all of them, and you know, they're the Big Four, not us, so it's cool, you know.
Okay.
What I mean?
Okay.
I mean, we've toured with most of those bands, not Metallica, but you know, I mean, they're friends of Gary. Tom and Gary grew up with the guys, and so there's
No.
We never felt like we
nobody's
were
sitting
deserved
drinking
to, yeah,
beer and
no. In fact,
you could have
the one
the Big Five,
the one Big Four show that Megadeth, David got hurt for the New York show, and Megadeth was gonna pull out, and they offered us the gig that day, and then Megadeth came back in, and then it didn't work out. But so kind of they were like, well, if anybody's gonna do it, we'll ask those guys, and you know, so I feel just good to have been thought about, even is great. Just to be even. For people to think about including us with, you know, those great bands is great.
What can we expect from this new record? What are going on?
You know, it's always hard to tell with Gary. You know, the cartoon mind of Gary Holt is always changing and morphing. I mean, it's going to be... I've heard some of it. Some of it's really fast, you know, very thrashy. It's not going to be any... It's not going to be anything that an Exodus fan isn't expecting from us. You know, we're not doing any power ballads this time or anything like that. It's a, you know, it's just good thrash metal, you know, with a twisted bend on it. And, you know, that's what we do.
Awesome.
So it's going to be furious, that's for sure.
If you had to choose your own shows or the festival shows?
Well, I mean, there's different things for different ones. I mean, it's great to play in front of more people than you will draw on your own. So to play to a sea of faces is great and awesome, open air type stuff. But then again, when you put us in a little tiny room with 200 Exodus fans, it's the most brutal thing ever, you know. I mean, nobody's safe in that room, and they're just two different types of interaction, you know what I mean? So we like them both. I mean, I like both. It's just kind of hard to say, you know, which one is better. You know.
Do you have a favorite Exodus song?
That it kind of shifts, you know. I mean, like you know, one of my favorites to play is Beyond the Pale right now. I just really like it. My hands feel good playing it, and that's a good one. But that always changes, you know. I change my mind. I get tired of one, and you know, I have ADD with music, you know. So. You know, I can't even decide who my favorite band is, really, you know, so.
What's your favorite band at the moment?
My favorite band of all time is Rush, but, you know, I mean, I go in and out of other things. I'm into so many different types of music. I play country music at home, and I pick banjo, and so I listen to tons of, like, vintage Nashville type stuff, you know, all the Dead songwriters, you know, Johnny and Waylon. I mean, all that old country music, I love it, and I love old big band music. I just love all kinds of shit, so it's hard to say. Like, sometimes I'm more into certain things than I am, you know, but this is my favorite type of music to play and perform. The energy exchange with this type of music is unlike any other type of music, you know, that you can do. Like, what we give and what we get back from the crowd, it's only metal, you know, really, really does that, you know, so that's easy,
you know. How much do you practice? Are you one of those people who sit like for 10 hours?
I've never really been that way. Like, it's like I said, I've been getting more into country music lately, so I play the banjo now, I play the mandolin and guitar and like the pedal steels and stuff, and I spend more time practicing that now because my mind, it's like opening doors in other places for me, and it even makes the metal, I play the bass better when I've been playing another instrument for a while. They just cross and open doors for each other. So I practice music all day long. You know, I'll get up, have coffee, smoke some weed, grab the banjo, play it for a while, set it down, pick up a guitar, play that, lay down, take a nap, wake up, grab something, and you know, I kind of noodle and songwrite all day long. So, I guess I do practice, you know, a lot.
So, not really practice, but all day long.
I just play music a lot, you know. I don't like sit and go, I need to learn this or learn that. I just kind of play music, and whatever comes, so. You know, I mean, with the bass playing, like, I kind of am, you know, my playing is where I want it to be, you know, for this band, and to get further into bass, I'd be doing all this weird jazz shit that I like to see, but I don't want to play it. You know, it's so it's just putting more. You know, I mean, I could put more energy into the bass, but it's not going to help me with Exodus so much. But everything helps. Every little thing you learn gets thrown into the pile and helps. So
and you evolve.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. Perfect.
This is Jack Gibson from Exodus, and you're watching Access Rock.